but my clay usually is a little stiff. So what I do is I let them dry a little bit, you know, from the clay that you have. I'm not blocking it. I let them dry a little bit. Try to keep the top a little thick. Notice I still have a lot of clay underneath. I'd like to use a rip. Now the top. I'll leave my top a little thicker. So when I thinking of, when I'm making this, I think about what I'm gonna use it for. So I think about, okay, I'm gonna put a flower. So that means a bouquet of flowers. So that means my rim has to be wider so I can have, right? I don't know, but I mean, when I make things, I think about what's the functionality, you know, what I'm gonna use it in. Okay, now, somebody is doing this, you take a bucket, take a porcelain, and this, of course you notice my surface is really dry, so, because it's slick, and they won't fall apart. Now your surface is really wet, you might challenge the integrity of a pot, because now I load them up. Oh yeah, went home with this. Maybe I'll get it one more time right here. I don't like this slip. It's because I made it last semester, so they dried out. Mm-hmm. Okay? So I went to blend it again, mm-hmm. but it didn't completely blend it well. So you can see almost like, did you ever have a, mashed potato with a lump? Hated it, but nothing I can do. Okay, now you can take a little wooden tools or any kind of tools. I think I have it right here. My favorite one that disappeared. I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna try to create a surface. Ugly, let's do it again. You can just keep playing until you like that. Or, that's another way to do it. I totally forgot how to do that. I did it once. What I did earlier with that one is, make sure my surface is flat. I'm thinking if you let your like dry a little more, it might be an interesting surface. Thank you. Yeah. You know me. So check that. I'll try to upload to the YouTube.
Turn that off for me.
11 minutes.